6 o'clock, Ed Hale, the CEO of First Mariner Bank, tells 11 News he's considering stepping down as part of a business deal to save the locally owned institution.
Hale founded First Mariner, which is Baltimore's largest independently owned bank. iTeam reporter David Collins asked Hale about his future and that of his bank this afternoon. David joins us live now from Canton.
Well, Donna, the burst of the housing bubble and the recession hit the bank hard. Founder and CEO Ed Hale says that the infuse of money will make the bank financially stronger, and he's confident it will continue to focus on Baltimore.
One of the things I want to make clear is that I'm not going to be an impediment. My employment, staying on as chairman or CEO, is not a condition.
Ed Hale, a major financial player, developer, the CEO of what has become an iconic East Baltimore landmark, is considering the unthinkable, relinquishing his top position of the local institution he founded. It's part of a deal he and the board of directors agreed to in order to save the bank. Premium Capital, a New York investment firm, will infuse $36.4 million into the bank. The deal is contingent on an additional $123 million of capital raised from other sources. The homegrown bank's finances have become strained after First Mariner started doing second mortgages in Northern Virginia. Mortgages the company sold to Bear Stearns, which went out of business.
They started sending loans back. We got $60 million worth of loans back from them. And when Wall Street starts failing, they eat their children to survive. And what had been done for decades just ended. And they started sending these loans back to us, and we had to take them back.
If the transaction succeeds, experts say it should bring financial stability to First Mariner. But the question remains, where will the $123 million come from?
6 months ago, would it be possible to raise $123 million? And what has changed in the next 6 months to say that's possible in terms of the portfolio of mortgages and other assets that First Mariner holds? So that, you know, it becomes a question of, is this possible in light of these market conditions and their asset sheet?
2 years ago, federal and state regulators demanded the bank raise more capital and deal with bad loans. The Sun paper reports First Mariner lost $46.6 million last year. Hale, who started in the trucking business, has become a fixture in the community. He owns the Baltimore Blast soccer team and has naming rights of the arena. He chairs the Tourism and Convention Board. He has several development projects in the works. Hale says even if he's no longer chief, he'll still be the largest stockholder, and the bank will still be local even when the new people take the helm.
These guys are local.
Okay.
Right. And they're going to be recognizable names.
Hale says he can't reveal those names just yet. He expects the deal to be completed by the fall. Reporting live from East Baltimore, David Collins, WBAL-TV 11 News.